Hiya friends!
Today we're doing a video on what's inside our pencil cases, because we get asked that quite a lot. Mm-hmm. So, let's jump into
Let's go take a look.
So, these are our pencil cases. Mine's, it was super cheap from Hobbycraft.
It was £1, that was. It's almost like a sack.
Sack!
But it's like a pencil sack, but it's really nice material, and it's super cheap too.
And then because Adam couldn't get this one, he went online and he ended up getting this one.
This was from Amazon, if I remember right.
I think it's by a company called Gusty Leather. I might be saying
it's
that
It's definitely
wrong.
Gusty something.
And every item that they make has its own name, and I think this one's called Felix.
Yeah, it is, although it's got like a H on it.
But yeah, let's get into opening these.
Okay.
First thing I want to talk about is the chameleon pen.
Hmm.
It can be a bit of a pain in the butt that it's a really chunky barrel, but I really like it because it's got the thinner end and the thicker end, and it's a fine liner pen.
I should probably start, because this is something that you use as well.
Oh.
It is a Blackwing pencil.
Oh, well that saves me showing mine. There we go. It was actually my art mentor that suggested that I try out this brand of pencil.
It was, yeah.
And Adam bought me some for my birthday, and I completely forgot about them for like half a year.
I've been like using them.
And now he's found them, and now he uses them.
I might as well show my Lamy pen. And I don't know much more information about it than the fact that it's a Lamy pen, because you got me this for my most recent
yeah,
birthday.
Yeah, I think technically it's a calligraphy one.
It's currently got blue ink in it. And I don't like wasting ink, so I'm trying to quickly get through using this so I can fill it up with black ink, and then it'll get used a lot more often.
What I'm going to show you next is the erasers that we use, because there's two. They're called Mono Zero erasers. It's basically, it's like a mechanical pencil where if you push down, you'll get more eraser. Basically, one's more of a chisel and the other one's quite a small, fine one. Another one we got recently is a Faber-Castell dustless eraser. It's very small because we cut it in half because we wanted to share it.
It lies, it is not dust-free at all.
Well, it's not dust-free. When you erase, it does make quite a mess, but it's very good at erasing. Every pencil I've used, it has rubbed out, so it
may... Yeah, and he's got some pencils that are so dark and he pushes down so hard that it's just,
yeah,
it's impossible to rub out. So the fact that this thing can budge some of that, that's
incredible. I like
incredible.
Carving to the table, but it's... What have you got in there?
I've got two Posca pens in here. I always try and bring like a silver, a gold, and a white.
Mm-hmm.
So today I've got a white and a silver in there. I've brought a blue highlighter with me.
That thing that you're holding upside down.
Am I? Anyone who's known me for a really long time knows that I usually love drawing with highlighter pens. And this dates back to like when I was a kid. And pink, green, yellow, and orange are kind of like the standard ones, and the blue one was the rare one, so this is like...
It was like, you've got the blue one?
And I have a purple one as well that I paid like a ridiculous amount of money to get
just to collect them.
But yeah, the blue one especially is a favourite of mine.
Because you used to have a character called Blue Ted, and you'd always colour him in. This is going back to like before we even knew each other.
Yeah.
When you were a kid, you had a character called Blue Ted,
well,
and that was the colour.
It's not necessarily a character, he is actually my bear.
If you've seen on my Instagram recently, my super, super kind friend Sam recently got me a tan sketchbook, and so I've been able to mess with white ink a bit more. This is very similar to like the Posca pen. This is a Zig Posterman pen, and that's pretty much the same sort of idea as a Posca pen. It's a white paint pen. I've drawn with so many things, and this goes over it without fail every time. These things, at first, especially if you don't know what they are, you might be like, what are these? I call them blending sticks, but I think they do have a proper name. Well, as you can see, they're kind of shaped like pencils, but they're made out of paper.
It's like a nice way to get a shading effect without using your fingers.
Because that's what I was doing before.
Because your fingers can add a lot of grease to the drawing, which isn't really advised.
Greasy fingers.
Everyone has oil in their fingers to some degree. Grease,
think
man.
It's like eating loads of pizza.
You do eat loads of pizza.
But I don't draw at the same time.
I already mentioned about how I bring like silver, white, and gold, so I think you've probably guessed there's going to be something golden here. And it's my new Kuretake gold ink brush pen. Oop. It is a bit of a nightmare to get hold of. I had to order this from Japan. Another inky brush favourite is called Pentel Colour Brush.
Yeah, something like that, yes.
Yet again, another like brush pen.
With a brush tip.
Ink when I did that. This is like a joint favourite of mine and Adam's. It's ink wash inside a Pentel Aquash.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, yeah.
Water brush.
Yes.
It's quite a mouthful. But ink wash is basically just water with a couple of dots of ink. I can't think of the proper word for it.
Drops?
Drops of ink. There we go, dots of ink.
It's pretty cool that you can customize these however you like. If you want a really dark one, add more ink. Or if you want a really light wash, just add more water.
Tons of my friends buy like a load of these and fill them with like different colored inks.
This is probably the number one thing we get asked, like, what is that? How do you use that? Why is that?
Non-stop,
red?
This is the thing that you are probably clicking on this video to even hear about.
So this is what it is, right? It is
the red pencil.
All this is a red pencil that you can erase.
Normally, I don't know if you've tried, if you try rub out a coloured pencil, it won't work. But with this, it will.
You can be as messy as you like with this, and you can guarantee that it'll go away if you erase it.
It's like a harder grade of pencil as well.
Oh, absolutely,
so
yeah, definitely.
You can't go too dark with it, which is kind of good for just drafting out the initial sketch.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I like using it to colour in cheeks and noses and ears.
Oh yeah, if you ever want to sketch in it in red, then you've got a red pencil as well. Oh, we don't have very many of these, but we do have a couple.
No. And we only use one, really.
This is the only one that we use, yeah. This is a warm grey Copic. Is it Chow? Is that how you say them?
I think so, and it's a W3, so I think that means warm grey 3.
It's very rare that you see us use these in doodle dates as well.
Yeah.
I can't remember the last time we used a Copic pen, but they're kind of expensive, so we don't get very
many. In terms of markers, we tend to use Spectrum Noir, and we've recently started using Pro markers. I have been binge buying Letraset Pro markers because they're like all on clearance sale at the moment, so like, if those are still around when this video goes live, check out the prices on Letraset Pro markers, guys.
Yeah, Letraset stuff at the minute is going really cheap, so if you want to pick up some markers,
I am in marker heaven. Normally I can't afford these things,
you have a
but
problem
this is incredible.
With
I do right now.
Okay, I'll try and quickly get through some stuff because Adam's only got like one item left and I have got tons of things in here.
You carry too much stuff.
Pentel ink brush pen. This is a staple in like every artist's pencil case. It's really easy to refill. Some people use it the ink up faster than others. For me, when I buy a pack of refills, this will last me like a year. Another one that I've recently started using again, this is technically the first ever ink brush I've had. I won this at a convention that I went to in about 2010 or something. I had no idea how to use it. I didn't even do traditional art at the time. It got shoved in a box under the bed. I picked it up in like recent years, drew a couple of times with it, decided I preferred the Pentel ink brush and started using that instead. But I have been using this just to block in backgrounds and stuff. Those are really similar, I hadn't realised before that.
Isn't it exactly the same?
Same company, yeah. For anyone interested, it's number 22. This is something that I think we both use from time to time, which is a red jelly roll pen. My brother got me this for Christmas in a set of them. Ironically, I'd asked him if he could get me a white jelly roll pen, and he got me like a set of ones that did not have a white in whatsoever, but had all the other colours. And at first I was kind of like, oh, okay, like, but they quite quickly turned into one of my favourite art supplies, and I'm so glad that he did end up getting me this set of
the
pens.
Colours and pigments in those are always super bright and colourful.
One that I think people are expecting to be in my pencil case, and it is, is a brown Crayola pen. And this is one of my all-time favourite pens.
The only felt tip in there.
We've bought about 3 sets of Crayola pens since we've been living together.
Yes, we only recently got some more.
Oh, something that I do really like to bring along with me is post-it notes.
In case, which you would have seen in the Frozen video.
I didn't do that with a post-it note, but that is kind of the concept of how I use them. If I ever screw up, I own my mistake. I put down a fabulous colour, so it's got a new little fluorescent square on the page. Draw on top and ta-da!
Like, look out, world, I've made a mistake.
These have totally turned into one of my new favourite art
supplies. Oh, yeah!
These are Faber-Castell Pitt pens, and I've got 2 different sets mishmashed in here. These are from the Landscape set, and these are from the Shades of Grey set. There are other sets that I'd be totally interested in buying based on the fact that I have loved using these so much. But these are lovely. They're not refillable or anything, which is a shame, but it's all just worth it to play with these. If you follow us on like Instagram, you'll have seen me experimenting with like tons of these things recently. And the last thing that I really want to talk about, which is also another one of my newest favourites, is this little Sharpie permanent marker. And it's got a super fine nib to it, so it's
like, oh, it's like a fine liner almost.
It bleeds like loads when you use it. And when I first got it, I was like, what am I going to use this for? It bleeds too much. But it creates such an interesting line variation that I've been using that quite a lot lately.
That's a fancy looking fine liner you got there.
Thank you.
Adam's got one last thing that you'd like to share with us.
Well, a couple. Just a standard HB pencil. Pretty much everybody always has these laying around, so it's always handy just to have a normal HB pencil around with you. I should probably show these together to explain why I've got these. I get through pencils really, really quick.
He really does. For me, a pencil will last me like 10 years or something. I very rarely sharpen them.
That right there is my most favourite pencil ever.
Oh, he gets through these like you would not believe.
It's a Mitsubishi Uni. I think it's Uni or Uni. Comes in 10B. It's like the softest pencil grade I think I've ever seen or heard of. It's really, really nice. It makes a really nice dark line. Only problem with it though is because it's so soft, you get through it like super fast. If you ever see one like in a shop, I would really recommend
it. Yeah, again, we usually have to import those from Japan.
These are Derwent pencil extender. So instead of being stuck with a load of pencil ends that I couldn't use, these are super, super useful to just get your little pencil end, you pop it in the top and screw it up. And you've got like a little pencil again.
Yeah, so it's a great way to get extra life out of your little pencil nubs.
It's definitely one of the most useful things I've bought recently because I've got so many of these laying around. Tell us what you use, you know, are we missing an essential that you use all the time?
We'll see you again next week for another doodle date.
Doodle date.
I think I was scratching my nose while you were telling us about that.